First came nuclear power. Then came Chuck Norris's power. And now the Resound Enzo IA power hearing aid. And Resound have got a lot to say about them. Did you know that it's estimated that between 5 to 10% of hearing aid users have a severe to profound hearing loss? And if you're one of them, then I wouldn't be surprised if you're feeling a little bit left behind when it comes to new technology. There is no question that innovation from the big hearing aid manufacturers shows up last for any of you guys, with incremental changes and long waits for those developments. Well, the good news is somebody has finally started looking out for you. This is the Resound Enzo IA, a superpower hearing aid that's smaller, rechargeabler, smarter in noise, and has built-in Auracast. And today I'm going to tell you honestly who should switch over to them and who shouldn't. So building on what I was saying before, there is no question that the likes of Resound, Phonak, Starkey, Widex, Signia or Oticon, so all of the big hearing aid manufacturers, focus the development of their newest technology where most hearing aid users are, which is for those of you out there with a mild to moderate hearing loss. In reality, this means that the BTE superpower hearing aids often lag behind, leaving those that need them with the challenges with the likes of speech clarity, power, whistling hearing aids, and unreliable battery life. With 86% of users still reporting challenges with speech understanding in background noise. Now, I don't want to get too excited now, but these are all areas that Resound are claiming to have improved their new technology beyond the capabilities of every other manufacturer. And if you've not considered their technology before, then now might be the best time to reach out to your audiologist and ask for a demo. So this is an interesting thought. Well, I'm saying it, so I think it's interesting. But I recently had a patient advise me that they've been to another practice who solely fitted one manufacturer of hearing aids. And they've been told that there was no point in trying any other manufacturer, as once you get used to one brand, it is impossible to get used to anything else. Now, you don't want to try any of those other rubbish TVs. It looks different. You'll never get used to it. Absolute nonsense. Maybe there's a common misconception. No, I'll reword that. There may be a not common misconception, but misconception that once you're used to a particular manufacturer's sound, you're locked for life. But it's just not true. I do think that that's possibly down to one manufacturer's clever marketing strategy in the past. If a new hearing aid comes out with incredible features, then I would absolutely recommend trying it out. Of course, any new technology does take time to get used to though. So if you've been using one particular manufacturer for a few years now, then there will be an acclimatisation period. But that even goes without saying if it's the same manufacturer too. Have faith in the process and your audiologist, it may well be worth your while. So why is it that Resound are so confident that if you try out this new technology, you will never look back? Well, Resound tell me that in a recent mammoth study of superpower hearing aid users, there were four standout features that were highlighted as being essential before users would even consider a new hearing aid. And so they've essentially built these Enzo IAs around those four key principles. And I would love to know if this is where your specific needs lie too, or if there's anything else that you deem as essential that they're not focusing their attention on. So let me know in the comments beneath today's video. So firstly, and I think quite obviously, is the desire for a noticeable improvement in sound quality, namely speech understanding in background noise. Secondly, the people demand no compromise on gain, i.e. as much power as possible. Thirdly, they voted for an improvement in connectivity and accessibility. And then finally, and fourthly, reliability when it comes to comfort with all day use, along with rechargeable batteries that will last for a full day without any question in terms of performance. So the big question is, have Resound managed this? And if so, how? Let's do some investigating. So kicking off with sound quality. Resound are boasting that their big improvements in speech understanding and noise all stem from their brand new 360 chip that processes your environmental sounds in real time using machine learning artificial intelligence. This new approach, which GN calls intelligence augmented, hence the name of these hearing aids, is GN's unique human approach to AI, allowing your hearing aids to adjust gain, noise reduction, and directionality to keep the person speaking in front of you nice and audible. This feature works in tandem with their clear focus feature, which in Resound's words is the hearing industry's most narrow directional beamformer that spotlights speech in front of you and eliminates distractions. With Resound's research showing that 93% of superpower hearing aid users prefer the sound of the new Enzo AIs versus their competitors. So if you live your life in cafes, classrooms, or busy kitchens, or you avoid these situations for not being able to hear, that narrow focus could be the difference between nodding along and actually tracking the conversation. Now, of course, I'm excited to verify and to obviously check how this feels or how this works outside of GN's labs in real patients' ears. And when I have, you'll see my full review of this technology. So make sure that you subscribe to be notified as soon as I've had the chance to fit them to plenty of my patients' ears and then give you the feedback that you deserve. Powerful hearing aids equals feedback nightmares. Now, if you're wondering why, in Resound's research, they found that there was a specific common issue reported around something as niche as gain, then there's a valid reason for this. Historically, there have been plenty of hearing aid manufacturers making powerful hearing aid technology, including Resound. However, there have also been occasions where the hearing aids or the systems built into those hearing aids haven't been able to cope with the amount of sound that they're producing. In turn, this leads to feedback, and one of the few ways to reduce this is to reduce the gain of the hearing aids, which from your point of view means less speech understanding and clarity. So GN's approach in this new technology is a little bit different. This is what they tell me. They're claiming to be able to cancel feedback without sacrificing the gain that you need for speech understanding, and they're boasting that they have up to 26 decibels, which is massive, may I add, more stable gain and faster suppression, so that if you're hugging someone, wearing a hat, or even putting your hand to your ear, those moments are less likely to cause squealing hearing aids. Now, on a side note, this doesn't replace a well-fitted ear mold, which is the foundation of reducing feedback. So if you still end up with a whistling hearing aid, then it's essential that you start with a new impression of your ear. Because I am a massive geek, I recently visited the UK's first train station to have installed Auracast transmitters, which allow for train announcements to be streamed directly to your hearing aids, so no more missing platform changes or announcements about delays. Not only are Resound the only manufacturers with a superpower hearing aid that can connect to this technology, but they're the first manufacturer with any hearing aid that allows you to connect, which for me is wild, and everybody else is chasing and just playing catch up. In turn, this currently means lower power consumption, more stable streaming, and multiple Bluetooth connections. And in the future, as Auracast transmitters roll out into public spaces, you'll be able to tune in to public announcements directly via the app. So think not just train stations, as I mentioned before, but also airports, stadiums, lecture halls, and yes, my clinic on Harley Street. And I have to tell you that patients love how immediate and clean it sounds versus the century-old loop system technology. From my experience in clinic, I know that some hearing aid users, especially those long-standing ones, which to be honest is probably most of you watching today's video, have historically avoided rechargeable hearing aids because of fear that they will die before your day is out. And this is where the Resound Enzo IA is trying to win over your heart and your confidence too. They will give you, this is what Resound are boasting, they will give you well over a full day of use at 28 hours for a full charge, or 20 hours if you stream for half of your day, which you're unlikely to do, I would have thought. And if you get caught short, a 10-minute supercharge in the charger will give you a full hour of use, or an hour will equate to 7 hours of use too. Plus, you can check your battery life in the Smart 3D app and top up whenever is convenient. But I wouldn't have thought that you'd need to do that. So my question to you is this enough to convince you to try rechargeable powered hearing aids? Or would you still have anxiety around this and prefer to keep the batteries in your pocket? Let me know in the comments beneath this video. As far as the fit goes, no, these hearing aids aren't small. But I have to say, they are the smallest superpower devices out there. Ergonomically curved to sit comfortably behind your ear, and because of that, it presses less on your glasses or masks. Those of you with hearing aids that are larger will know better than I about how uncomfortable they can get during the course of a day, and comfort shouldn't be a luxury. It's essential for your all-day use. So, the main question is, should you try them? Now, I guess the big question to ask is, if any of the following statements resonate with you, then it's worth booking in with your audiologist for a demonstration. Firstly, if you struggle in noise and your current hearing aids don't give you the speech focus that you need. Secondly, if you're maxed out on gain or constantly dancing with feedback. Thirdly, if you want to try the best Bluetooth technology out there. And then finally, if you're tired of changing batteries once a week, then these are all reasons why you should try these hearing aids. But before you do, you should check out this video covering the best hearing aids available this year.